Hello and welcome back to the MU Bumblebee build in part 6, where we finally put everything together and finish up where we left off last, was finishing one of the feet. As you can see here, we're going to pick up where we left off, build the torso, and bring it all together. I bent the connection tabs sort of inward to line them up with the corner slots, but when I went to attach the two pieces together, it made more sense to bend the tabs outward instead. Thank you. Now it's time to start putting together some larger assemblies. I had to use a pick to reach in and bend over some tabs. There are a lot of little bits and pieces to add to this abdomen area before we finish the assembly. I have to give this round part an extra pinch to round it out and allow it to fit in its spot. It wasn't wanting to fit with its neighboring part. I must have folded that half circle part backwards as the cutouts did not line up where they needed to. I am bending over most of the tabs inside the torso. In some instances, I am pinching the tabs together to start the bend. Thank you. These three pieces fold up the same. It is important to make sure the magnetic poles are lined up properly when you're placing these two magnets. To achieve this, I placed the plate that holds these magnets over the plate with the section of magnets already installed and used it as a guide to properly line the magnets up. The magnets will pretty much flip to the correct side when you place them in the spot. And then I carefully lifted that plate away. Make sure to line up the lines. I didn't use any of my tools to bend the sides over here because I didn't want to unintentionally pull the magnet out of its spot by bringing a metallic tool too close to it. And there we go, we're finally finished. All the different pieces have come together. And we've got this beautiful, very relaxed looking bumblebee. Such wonderful detail, interesting choice. they decided to make it so that it's two pieces that connect together with magnets. And also interesting, I like the little addition of the radio we've got here. Interesting bit, there's a magnet that holds it on, but it's only going to hold certain places because the gold sheets are not metal, or not magnetic, whereas the silver pieces are. The gold was a little soft and easy to break and difficult to work with. It's definitely a very challenging model, but such wonderful detail as we've come to expect with the MU builds. Bumblebee is a bit smaller than Optimus Prime and Megatron, but from what I remember, that was typically the case back in the cartoon days. So there you go. There's a full review coming very soon. I want to thank you for watching. As always, if you have any other questions or comments, feel free to leave them down below. And thank you to MU for sending me this model to build. If you didn't already know, MU actually sent this to me as kind of a thank you for my already published MU build videos, and for, I guess, me to build and review as well. So thank you very much, MU, for sending me this model. What a wonderful model, and what a lot of fun it was to build. Thank you for watching, and keep on keeping on.